Welcome to another installation of video broadcasting from Dove Christian Center Church, also known as Dove Church. And we just wanted to say a great Palm Sunday to everyone. And from the words of the song, "Ride on, King Jesus, ride on, conquering King." We thank you for tuning in, and we are praying for you all. We trust that God will just continue to bless in families, soothe the grieving, encourage hearts. We thank God for healings. We thank him that even in this time of COVID-D, that there are many people that are getting healed and are walking out of hospitals. And we encourage you to focus in on those things too. And today, we're going to start in. First, we're going to say our confession that we normally say each time before a message. And it's, this is my Bible. I am what it says I am. This book calls me an overcomer, and that's who I am. Today, I shall be taught the infallible, unchanging word of God. So my mind is alert, my heart is receptive, as I gladly receive the word today. I believe that faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Father, we thank you for what we're about to share, for what we're about to receive from you, even during this time. Now we bless every listener that we go on to not only be listeners, but doers of the word. So, Lord, let the word of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight. O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. Well, today's message is Courageously Humble. Courageously Humble. These are humbling times. There's a posture that the church must rally to take. It is the posture of unified submission. Our submission is also a courageous stand. Be clear, the church's submission is only to God. But we must have courage in the face of pestilence and tribulation. It's through this level of submission that we come low but rise full of courage to proceed. In this message, I will deal with two scripture passages that are somewhat similar but different. They are similar in that both must confront an enormous challenge. It seems Joshua, the successor to Moses, had a submission and courage problem that had to be addressed if he were to lead God's people. Joshua was in front of the fortified city of Jericho, and in spite of him being one of the two spies who came back with a good report, he was still fearful. In spite of him coming back and saying, "We are well able to take the land," he still needed courage. And so we run quickly to our first scripture, Joshua 1, 8, 9. And it's interesting where it starts out at, because it starts out admonishing Joshua where to start. And then it tells him what he has, and then he gets an encouragement through this word. Joshua 1, 8 through 9 says, "This book of the law shall not depart from your mouth, but you shall meditate in it day and night, that you may observe to do according to all that is written in it, for then you will make your way prosperous, and then you will have good success." That word, "you shall make your way prosperous, and then you will have good success," that "then you will have good success" is mentioned in this first chapter 6 times. So it is commanded, and it is established through repetition that you will have good success. Courage. What is courage? Courage is the ability to act in faith despite danger or disapproval. Let's unpack the verses. Be strong and very courageous. Joshua is called to boldness in God. This, just that call exposes Joshua's weakness. There was a need for such a command because he needed this encouragement. This bold courage would not be Joshua himself, but in God. Let me say, we can be full of confidence, but that will take us to ruin. But we should instead be full of a genuine confidence propelled by his grace, which is, as I stated last week, grace is God's free empowerment that gives us the ability to go beyond our natural ability. Then the next verse says that you may observe to do according to all the law. Joshua must take care to observe, look at it closely, and put it into practice, the word of God. Joshua must be courageous while humbling himself to God's word. The commitment to God's word would be the pillars supporting his success. Joshua did not only need to read God's word, it had to be on his lips. Shall not depart from your mouth. It had to be in his mind. Meditate in it day and night. And he had to do it. Observe to do according to all that is written. And then the next verse says, for then, remember I said later, we're going to unpack the for then you will make your way prosperous, and then you will have good success. God's word lived is a guarantee of Christian success. Not that it promises a life without problems, but it does ensure a life able to deal with anything. It takes full advantage of God's presence and promise. And we must have both God's presence and we've got to have his promise. And then the next verse says, this is where we all need to land. This is where we all need to rest. This is where we all need to reside. It said, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. And in this time of tribulation and testing that we are going through, you must know as a believer that the Lord your God is with you. He's with you even now. He's with you in the trouble. God had to deal, basically in this Joshua 1, 8, 9, with the heart of the leader. And that's what God is doing in this day. He's dealing with the heart of leadership. And so as we move forward, the question of being courageous through the grace of God and humbling oneself again appears to us in another passage. And it's at the dedication of the first temple built by Solomon. Solomon is entreating the Lord for his presence in this house. But the Lord returns based on Solomon's request, a sobering prophetic statement. And it's found in 2 Chronicles 7:13. It starts out with a statement of judgment. And it says, when I shut up heaven and there is no rain, or command the locusts to devour the land, or send pestilence among my people. He said, when I shut it up, meaning that it's going to happen. Here is God's solutions to the intended judgment in verse 13. 2 Chronicles 7:14 says, and it's almost a but if, but it says if. He said, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray, seek my face, turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and will forgive their sins and heal their land. The verse calls the people of God together as a prescription for changing the conditions in the land. I believe in this time we have a prescription for changing the condition of the pestilence in this land. It is this people that he claims for himself who call him their God. It's with those people. It's time for this people to rise up and respond to what God says. If my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray, seek my face, turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and will forgive their sins and heal their land. Well, let's go back and unpack a few things because we want to broaden our understanding of the verse we just read. Humble in Hebrew is the word anev. It means to prostrate oneself. It is the act of physically and spiritually lowering oneself. It also means to get small. The plural for this word is anevim, meaning a whole group, a whole collection, a whole congregation, a whole nation, a whole world needs to prostrate themselves or get small. Anevim, get small. Well, in Jamaican culture, there is a statement that they say out of a lot of Jamaican slangs, and it's called, small up yourself, man. Small up yourself. When moving around, visiting different sites in Jamaica, you may need to board a bus or a taxi. However, there are times when the buses and taxis are crowded and there's inadequate space. This is where this Jamaican expression becomes useful because it means make room. Is what the phrase means. And when you want to have some space so you can pass, it is what you might say to someone around you. Small up yourself, man. Small up yourself. Just maybe in this time, God is saying, small up yourselves. Make room for me. Make room for my presence. Invite me in. And when you do that, I'll come in. In 2 Chronicles 7:14, are four simple words. I read the scripture to you twice. 2 Chronicles 7:14. And in those, here are four simple words. If you don't remember much else, these are the words that jump out. This is the prescription in these words. Humble, pray, seek, turn. Humble, pray, seek, turn, in that order. Because you can't turn without being humble. You can't seek without praying. Humble, pray, seek, turn. But these words come before the word then. Because the next part of that phrase is, then will I. But let's stop at the word then. Then means at this time, or after the previous set of circumstances. Well, today, then, tomorrow, or then, right now. So then means again, at this time. Is it possible that God is saying that when the requirement is met, then at this time or at that time, I will forgive their sins and heal the land? Humble, pray, seek, turn. Then at that time, I will forgive your sins and heal the land. Blessings to you all. This is our message for today. And we trust that you received something. We trust that you got something out of it. We trust that you were blessed by it. We trust that everywhere you go that you will stay in faith. While the first verse spoke to Jericho and Joshua as it relates to God speaking to a man, the second verse spoke to a nation. So God is speaking to our leadership, and he's speaking to a nation. And we're hoping that you and ears have ears to hear what the Spirit is saying to the churches and what he's saying to our nation. And so with that, we bless you and thank God for you. If you heard this message today, we want to give you an opportunity to give your life to the Lord Jesus Christ, and we want to pray with you right now. You can say these words with me. Father, in Jesus' name, I repent of my sin, and I give you my life. Today, I make Jesus Lord of my life. I renounce sin and Satan. I believe that one day, God raised Jesus up from the dead. And on that confession and on that belief, I am saved. And I thank God I am saved to the glory of God. In Jesus' name, amen. If you prayed that prayer, we need to hear from you. If you want to contact us, let us know that you gave your life to the Lord today. Contact us at dove_church@yahoo.com. dove_church@yahoo.com. We're believing for you. We're praying for you. We're praying for all of you that are going through much right now. But we know that we are more than conquerors because the Lord is with us. And in the way of announcements, we want to say on next Sunday, Easter Sunday, we will be doing drive-by communion. And it will start at 10 a.m. through 11:30 a.m. We will line you up. It will be very orderly. You will get your communion and prayer and drive right on off. We want to make sure that this is a special time and remembering the resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Also, remembering what he's done for us through his death, his burial, and his resurrection. And so we look forward to seeing you. Dove, we thank you for your constant prayers and your support. And we pray for you again that God would just meet every one of your needs. To our listening audience and our viewing audience, we are praying mightily for you. And we're constantly in prayer that God would just kick back this pestilence, and that we will have miraculous testimonies all over the place. If you can't tolerate social media because all you get is the negative, turn to the Word of God. Find some place that has a positive report, has a God report. And the question is, whose report will you believe? We will believe the report of the Lord. God bless you until we come together next time. Blessings to you, dear friends. Thank you for joining us in our video presentation and word message. We'd also like to encourage you to assist us in giving by going to our webpage and finding dovechurch.org, going to the giving link that will take you to our PayPal page. And we look forward to your support and your love. Thank you for tuning in.